Good afternoon, students. Good afternoon, all of you. Okay, we revised that increasing decreasing function, tangent and normal, because you are having test tomorrow, increasing decreasing and tangent and normal. So we just revised that increasing decreasing and tangent and normal. Okay, increasing and decreasing functions. Okay, please try to understand. My f is increasing if my f dash of x is greater than 0. F is increasing, my f dash of x is greater than 0 for every x belongs to that interval, open interval a comma b. Okay, my f is decreasing. F is decreasing means my f dash of x is negative for every x belongs to this interval a comma b. Okay, my f is constant. That means no increasing, no decreasing. Okay, so if my f dash of x is equal to 0 for every x belongs to this interval. Okay, right. Now look at that. Dear students, please try to understand. Suppose the curve is coming like that. The curve is coming like that. Look at that. In 0 comma some a, and this is some a, this is some b. Okay, and this is some b. Now look at that, and this is, I'm taking some minus a, minus a to my minus a to plus a, my curve is increasing. See this curve, minus a to a, my curve is increasing. That means from minus, in this interval minus a comma a, my f is increasing. See the curve, see the diagram. What is increasing? Increasing means the value of f of x is rising. Okay, increasing. My value of f of x is increasing from minus a to plus a. When x is equal to minus a to plus a, my f of x is increasing. That means my f is increasing in this interval. Okay, and look at that. From minus this a to b, this a to b, my f is decreasing. Look at that, my f is decreasing. The value is reducing and reducing, reducing up to this. My value is reducing from a to b. So therefore, in a to b, my f is decreasing. This arrow mark is the symbol for decreasing. This arrow mark is the symbol for increasing. But don't use these arrow marks in your exams. This is for just an understanding. Instead of writing increasing, decreasing, I'm just using that arrow mark. Don't write this arrow mark in your exam. Okay, so this is decreasing. Again, look at that. From B to C, my function is, again, it is increasing. Here it is decreasing. From B to C, my function is again increasing. So therefore, for this interval, my function is increasing. For this interval, my function is decreasing. For this interval, my function is again increasing. Okay. But in that domain, entire domain, my function is neither increasing nor decreasing. Totally, suppose if you consider that your x value is the entire domain real number, my function is neither increasing function nor decreasing function. But in some particular interval, my function is increasing and decreasing. Okay, right. So this is a theorem. So this is from the diagram. From the diagram, we can observe f is increasing or f is decreasing. This is mathematical procedure to find f is increasing or decreasing. If my f dash of x is greater than 0 in this interval, my f is increasing in this interval. My f dash of x is less than 0 in this interval, my f is decreasing in this interval. My f dash of x is 0, my f is constant in this interval. Okay, right. Okay, sir. All these are mathematical procedures. Okay. Then how to solve the given problem, how to find the intervals of the given function is in which interval the given function is increasing, in which interval the given function is decreasing, right? Suppose let us take the question. If my f of x is given, f of x is equal to 4x cube minus 6x square minus 72x plus 30. So the question they are asking, the function at find the intervals at which the function is increasing or decreasing. Find the intervals at which interval this given function is increasing, at which interval my given function is decreasing. See that in this interval my function is increasing and this interval my function is decreasing. Again, this interval b to c my function is increasing. Like that you find out intervals for this function, in which interval that is increasing, which interval it is decreasing. For this type of problem you have to follow three steps. Okay, first step is find the derivative and factorize this. Find the derivative. What is answer? 3 4s are 12x square. This is 2 6s are 12x minus 72. This is 0. This is my derivative. After finding derivative, factorize this. Taking 12 commonly, this is x square minus x minus 6 equal to 0. Right? And now factorize this, minus 6 minus 1. I need minus 1. When you add the two numbers, we need minus 1. When you multiply these two numbers, I want to get minus 6. So that is 2 into 3 plus 2 minus 3. 2 3s are minus 6 and 2 into minus 3. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. So therefore, this is 12 into x plus 2, x minus 3. This is not equal to 0. Only x square minus x minus 6. Okay. The first step is, dear students, finding the increasing, not only for tomorrow's test. Yeah, yeah, we will do. We will do, ma. Okay. 12x plus 2, x minus 3. Okay. The first step is f dash of x is equal to 12 of x plus 2, x minus 3. That means factorize. Come to this, my second step. My second step is let f dash of x is equal to 0. F dash of x is equal to 0 means 12 of x plus 2, x minus 3 equal to 0. Okay. So therefore, my x is equal to minus 2 and plus 3. Then my third step is, come to the number line. Okay, plot these points, minus 2, 3. Here this end is minus infinity, this end is plus infinity. That means this is one interval, first interval. This is my second interval, this is my third interval. Okay, what are the intervals? Intervals are minus infinity, comma minus 2, minus 2, comma 3, and 3, comma infinity. Okay, what is my sine of f dash of x? My sine of f dash of x. In this interval, what is the sine of f dash of x? That means you apply any one value in your f dash of x. This is, actually this is your f dash of x. Apply any one value from this interval. I can take it as minus 3. Minus 1 not in this interval, only minus 3. Okay. So what about minus 3? Apply minus 3 here. This is minus 3 plus 2. Minus 3 plus 2 negative. Here also minus 3 negative. So here also I am getting negative. Here also I am getting negative. Negative into negative. It is positive. That is my f dash of x is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means my natural of f of x. Okay, what is my natural of f of x? If f dash of x is greater than 0, see this, my f dash of x is greater than 0, my f is increasing. That means my f is strictly increasing or increasing. Okay, right. Similarly, apply any one value from this interval, minus 2, comma 3. So apply 0. When you apply 0 here, this is positive, this is negative. So positive into negative, I am getting negative. That is less than 0. Less than 0 means strictly decreasing. Okay. And the third one, you can apply 4. Apply 4 here in your f dash of x. 4 plus 2, it is 6. Positive. Here 4 minus 3, it is 1. Positive. Positive into positive, it is my f dash of x is positive. So therefore, this is strictly increasing. So for your exam also, subjective test exam also, you can follow only these three steps. Complete this table. Okay, so this is a method to find your function in which interval the given function is increasing or decreasing. Okay, right, pa? And some student asking some doubts. F of x is e^2x. Are you okay about this? You follow three steps. 1, 2, 3. For increasing, decreasing mean two. So only three steps. Okay. Come to that. My f of x is equal to e^2x. Right. What is my first step? Find f dash of x. What is the differentiation? e^2x into 2. This is not possible to factorize. For a polynomial function, this is polynomial. Polynomial means I can easily factorize. But this is not a polynomial function. Not to factorize. So therefore, then go for the second step. F dash of x is equal to 0. So then 2 into e^2x is equal to 0. My e^2x is equal to 0. So then what is the answer? My e^2x. So it is not possible to conclude. Are you okay? So look at that. This is not possible to conclude. My e^2x is 0. When my e^2x is equal to 0. Okay. When my x is equal to 0, e^0 is equal to 1. But I need 0. My e^2x is equal to 0. When it is 0, it is undefined 1. That means my e^-infinity only 0. Are you okay, pa? e^-infinity only 0. Then what is that, sir? That means, okay. So this is not possible to apply. That means it is not possible to find out that critical point. So then it is not possible to find out the critical point means what we do, sir. Then go for the definition. This is a definition. Increasing, decreasing function definition. My x1 less than x2, which implies my f of x1 less than f of x2. My f of x1 less than f of x2. Okay, so then which implies my f is increasing. If my x1 less than x2, if my f of x1 greater than f of x2, then my f is decreasing. This is the actual definition. This is the actual definition. This is, what's are this method, sir? This first step, second step, third step, all these are, we are using this theorem. This is a theorem. I'm using this theorem, but here for this problem, the theorem is not applicable. Because it is not possible to find out the critical points. What is critical points? When my f dash of x is equal to 0, at which point my f dash of x is equal to 0, that point is called as my critical point. But here not possible to find out my critical points. So therefore, then go for the definition. So then what to do, sir? Okay. How to find out this? Right. So suppose I am taking this x1 less than x2, right? Look at that, which implies ninth question. Okay, pa, I will explain. Don't worry. I will explain, pa. Okay, so see that this is the e^x diagram. Graph of e^x. This is my graph of e^x. Okay, so from the graph, I'm going to conclude that suppose I'm taking two value, x1 and x2. My x1 is less than x2. If my x1 is less than x2, okay, what about my e^x1? My e^x1 is less than e^x2. This is my e^x1, this is my e^x2. Actually, this is my e^x1, this is my e^x2. look at that, my e power x2 is always, this is actually e power x1 value, y value. This is my e power x2 value, this y value. This y value is greater than this y value, e power x1 value. That means e power x2 is greater than e power x1 when x2 is greater than x1. Okay, from the graph, we can conclude that x1, when x1 less than x2, which implies e power x1 less than e power x2. Sir, you are taking only 2 points from the right hand side. Can I take the points here? I am not taking the point, particular point. These 2 points are any 2 points in the domain. Sir, I wish to take 2 points here and here, sir. Yeah, take it. Again, you will get e power x1 less than e power x2 only. Sir, I wish to taking 1 point from here and here, sir. This is my x1, this is my x2. Yeah, look at the curve. This is my e power x1, this is my e power x2. My e power x2 is greater than e power x1. Sir, I'm going to take it 1 point from here, 1 point from here, sir. Yeah, see that. Here, this is my e power x1. Here, it maybe comes here, e power x2. This is very big. Okay, so therefore, also for any two values of x1 less than x2, my e power x1 less than e power x2, see the graph. This is a e power x graph. Okay, exponential graph. That is a dramatic increasing. When you give a changing of small value of x, okay, the resulting e power x is increasing more. That is an exponential curve. Okay, right. So which implies it satisfies this condition. Look at that. This shows that the first one, my x1 less than x2, my f of x is less than f of x2. Therefore, my f is increasing. My f is increasing means my e power 2x is increasing. So which implies from this condition, I'm concluding that f of x is increasing. Are you okay, Pa? Why I'm coming to this method? Because I'm not able to find out the value, because e power minus 1 infinity only 0. That means your 2x is equal to minus infinity. I will get x is equal to minus infinity. It is undefined. My e power minus infinity only 0. Look at that. Right? When my x is equal to minus infinity, my y is 0. Okay, approaching 0. Right? Are you okay, ma? Yeah. I think you can understand this problem. And look at the ninth one. Exercise ninth one problem. Prove that, the question is prove that y is equal to 4 sine theta divided by 2 plus cos theta minus theta is an increasing function on theta in 0 comma pi by 2. Okay. So now, now you have to follow the procedure. There are three steps. What are the three steps? You can take, this is actually f of theta. Okay. F of theta, 4 sine theta divided by 2 plus cos theta minus theta. What is your first step? Find the derivative. That means differentiate. Apply u by v formula. What is your u by v formula? U by v formula is u dash v minus u v dash by v square. Look at that, dear students. So many of the students are getting confusion about this formula. They are writing the first step is u v dash. The first step, first term is u dash v and second term is u v dash. Therefore, u dash v minus u v dash divided by v square. Are you okay, Pa? So therefore, apply that here 2 plus cos theta r. Differentiate this 4 into sine theta differentiation is cos theta, and this differentiation is 0. Cos theta differentiation is minus sine theta. Oh, I'm sorry. This differentiation is cos theta. Okay, 4 is there. You can write this 2 plus cos theta as it is. Minus 4 sine theta into differentiation of this. 2 differentiation is 0. Cos theta differentiation is minus sine theta. Whole divided by the 2 plus cos theta the whole square. Look at that. This is a differentiation of this term u by v. Here, look at that. Separately, one theta is there. Theta differentiation is one because we are differentiating with respect to theta. I am differentiating with respect to theta. Theta is the independent variable. Okay. Now simplify this. What happened? Factorize this. Apply this. 2, 4, 8 cos theta. This is 4 cos square theta. Okay, and this is minus into minus plus 4 sine square theta whole divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square minus 1. So therefore, this is 8 cos theta. This is taking 4 commonly, cos square plus sine square is 1. So therefore, this is 4 divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square minus 1. This is my first derivative. Okay. Is it possible to simplify further? Just take a cross multiplication. Take a cross multiplication. What happened for here? Take a cross multiplication here. 8 cos theta plus 4. Divided by 2 plus minus half 2 plus this is, I'm just cross multiplying 2 plus cos theta the whole square by 2 plus cos theta the whole square. So this is 8 cos theta plus 4, right? Simplify this, apply a plus b the whole square formula. This is a square plus b square, okay, plus 2ab. 2 into cos theta, 2ab, okay, whole divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square. Okay, so this is 8 cos theta plus 4, this is minus 4, minus cos square theta. Okay, this is 2 into 2, 4, minus 4 cos theta divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square. Okay. So now look at that. Here this 4 and 4 get cancelled. This is, look at that, 8 cos theta minus 4 cos theta. What is the answer? So that is 4 cos theta minus cos square theta divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square. Okay. Here also you can take cos theta outside. 4 minus cos theta divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square. Okay, now dear student, now look at that. This is my f dash of theta. Okay, are you clear, pa? I am completing only the first step. I just completed only the first step, my f dash. I'm just finding f dash and simplifying. Okay, what about my second step? Okay, taking f dash of theta is equal to 0, find the theta value. But there is no need for that. Why, sir? Because it is given. Look at that. Your theta is given. What is theta? 0 to pi by 2 is given. The interval is given. No need to find out. So for finding that interval only, I need that x value. If you get x value, then go for number 9 and fix it my x value. And we can split it in intervals. But interval is given. No need for the second one. Okay, we no need the second in second step. Directly we can write that interval. Okay, look at that. If r given theta belongs to this 0 comma pi by 2, right? Okay, if my theta belongs to this 0 comma pi by 2 that is given, what about my f dash of theta? That is a question. My f dash of theta is equal to, actually what we are getting, cos theta 4 minus cos theta, okay, divided by 2 plus cos theta the whole square. Okay, so when you apply theta is equal to any value from this 0 to pi by 2, what is your f dash of theta? If your f dash of theta is greater than 0, then my f of x is, f of theta is increasing. If I'm getting my f dash of theta is less than 0, my f dash of theta is decreasing. this is okay, but the question is it is increasing. Okay, no problem. Now come to that, this is positive or negative pa? This value is greater than 0 or less than 0? This term I am writing one by one, and this term, that is 4 minus cos theta, this is positive or negative? This cos theta is positive or negative? There are three terms, 1, 2, 3, there are three terms. Okay, what about my cos theta, positive or negative? What about my 4 minus cos theta, positive or negative? What about my 2 plus cos theta, the whole square, that is positive or negative? Which one positive, which one negative pa? Which one positive? Here I am writing three terms, 2 plus cos theta, the whole square, 1, 4 minus cos theta, 2, and cos theta, 3. Look at that, this is always positive. Why? Since the square term is always positive. Okay, greater than or equal to 0, or strictly greater than 0. My square term is always positive. Okay, and this is also greater than 0. Why? Look at that, my cos theta always lies between minus 1 to plus 1 only. The maximum value of theta is 1. The minimum value of theta, cos theta, is minus 1. Okay, if you apply the minimum value here, cos theta, minimum least value of cos theta, minus 1, 2 minus 1, it is 1. 1 square is 1. Okay, it is greater than 0, positive. Okay, and look at that here, my cos theta maximum value is plus 1 only. If you apply that maximum value, we are getting 4 minus 1, 3. 3 is positive. Okay, right. Now come to that cos theta. What about my theta? My theta belongs to the first quadrant. This is the first quadrant. See that? In first quadrant, my cos theta value is positive or negative? It is positive. What about sine theta? That is also positive. What about the other trigonometric angle values in the first quadrant? All are positive, all silver teacups. All are positive. So therefore, see that this is positive, this is positive, this is positive. So therefore, the entire function is positive. Are you okay, pa? This is positive, this is positive, this is positive. This is because of square, it is positive. This is my cos maximum value is 1 only. Okay, it is not possible to write that my cos theta is equal to 2. Okay, the range of the cos theta is, cos function is minus 1 to plus 1 only. So if you apply that maximum value of cos theta 1, 4 minus 1, you will get 3, positive value. Here square is there, positive value. My cos theta in the first quadrant, that is also positive. This is positive, this is positive, this is positive. Then the entire value of this expression is also positive. That means my conclusion is my f dash of theta greater than 0. If my f dash of theta is greater than 0, from by theorem, my f of theta is increasing. Increasing on the given interval. What is the given interval? 0, pi by 2. Are you okay, pa? Are you clear? Yes, very good. Any other doubts? Okay, look at that. This type of problem, my f of x is x power 100 plus sine x minus 1. Okay, is strictly increasing in which interval? The question is f of x is strictly increasing in which interval? Okay. In which interval? The options are given. Look at that. The options are 0, 1, first option, second option, pi by 2, pi, third option 0 comma pi by 2, fourth option none. That means you apply this interval is given. That means the question is the function is strictly increasing in which interval? That is the question. So therefore, so you please first of all find your f dash of x. First step, what is my f dash of x? My f dash of x is equal to, that is 100 x power 99. Okay, this is sin x definition is cos x minus 1. Okay. But look at that. If my take one by one interval, actually minus one definition is zero. Yes. Now come to that interval. Apply the interval one by one in 0, 1. Okay. So look at that. This is actually positive. In 0, 1, this is my positive value. Okay. And my cos x is also positive in this interval 0, 1. Okay, so this is my cos x curve in 0, 1. My cos x is also positive value. So therefore, in 0, 1, my cos x is positive, greater than 0, and 100 x power 99. That is also positive. Okay, positive plus positive is positive. My f dash of x is greater than 0, positive, which implies my f is strictly increasing. But the question is, what is the question? At which interval? Yeah, the question is, I'm sorry, the question is strictly decreasing. The question is strictly decreasing. X power 100 plus sine x minus 1 is strictly decreasing in which interval? Okay, but here for the first interval, I'm getting strictly increasing. Come to the second interval. What is my second interval? My second interval is pi by 2 comma pi. Okay, so clearly this is my positive 100 x power 99. That means you can apply any one value from this pi by 2 to pi. Pi by 2 is nothing but my pi is 22 by 7, 180 degree or 22 by 7. Okay, this is pi by 2 means that is 22 by 14 by 2. Okay. Right, it is a numerical value. Apply positive value, I am getting only greater than 0 positive. What about my cos x? What about my cos x? This is in the second quadrant. Okay, my in my second quadrant, my cos x is less than 0. Okay, then what about my f dash of x? Any idea? This f dash of x, 100 x power 99 plus cos x. Look at that, this cos x value is negative, okay, but this value is positive. But you note that very important point, my 100 x power 99 is greater than this cos x, this value. Whatever you are getting, my cos x value, I am getting negative values, so no problem. Because what is my cos x? My range of the cos x is always less than or equal to 1 only. Plus 1, okay, and minimum is minus 1 only, okay. So therefore, this maximum value is 1 only. But here, if you apply this pi value 22 by 7 or 3.14 here, or this 22 by 7 by 2, that is 1.5 here, this is a max big value compared to this cos x. So therefore, this is bigger, this is smaller, this is positive, this is negative. Finally, I will get the positive answer because this is a bigger one, this is a smaller one. And subtract, when you subtract and put the bigger sign, that is plus. So therefore, which implies my f dash of x, f of x is, okay, increasing only. Positive means increasing. Similarly, the third case also, what is my third case? 0, pi by 2. Okay, the third case is 0, pi by 2. This is very simple. In 0, pi by 2, my cos x is positive, first quadrant. Okay, 0, 1 by 2. Actually, 0, this is pi by 2. Right, that is greater than 0, positive only. Right, and my this is also positive, 100 x power 99. That is also positive because this is positive value. Apply positive value, you will get definitely positive value. my f dash of x is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means my f is increasing, strictly increasing. So in this case also strictly increasing, this case also strictly increasing, this case also strictly increasing. So therefore the option is none. Okay, are you clear, pa? Students, are you okay for that? Okay, pa. Right. So now we'll go for that tangent and normal. Okay. Come to that tangent and normal. It is a very simple and very interesting topic, tangent and normal. Okay. Six point three, 13th question, apa? Okay. So first of all, look at that. What is tangent equation? My tangent equation is y minus y one equal to m into x minus x one. Please try to understand what is x one, what is y one, okay? What is m? Suppose look at this is the curve, any curve, and at this point P, the point is x one comma y one. This is the point x1 comma y1 on the curve. I am taking one point on the curve. At this point, I am going to find out my tangent line. Tangent line means a line touching the curve. That touching point is P x1 comma y1. This x1 y1 is the coordinates of the point. That is the point of contact of the tangent, which is a point on the curve. At which at this point only we are drawing the tangent. That is the meaning. Coordinates of the point, not a x1, y1 means not the derivatives, okay? And in your book, they are using x0, y0, okay? You can use x0, y0 also, no problem. And this is my tangent. Tangent means the line touching the curve. The line touching the curve is called as my tangent, okay? Right, this equation is this. How to find out this equation? Y minus y1, this y1 equal to x minus x1 into m. M mean the slope of this tangent. What is the slope of the tangent? My slope of the tangent, m is equal to slope of the tangent. Okay, what is my slope of the tangent? Tan theta, tan of this theta. Angle making the line by the x-axis. Okay, tan theta, dy by dx. Okay, at the point x1 comma y1. Okay, so this is our slope of the tangent. Okay, we have to find out the slope of the tangent. My slope of the tangent is, usually we are finding the slope of the tangent is this way, finding dy by dx and applying the point at which point we are drawing the tangent, apply the point. Okay, you'll get some numerical value, that is where slope of the tangent, apply that. Okay, come to that, what is normal equation? Normal, this is y minus y1 is equal to minus 1 by m x minus x1. Normal means the line perpendicular to this tangent and passing through the same point P, x1, y1. Okay, this is my normal equation. That is also a straight line. This is the normal equation, y minus y1 is equal to minus 1 by m, x minus x1. Okay, so that means if your m is the slope of the tangent, then minus 1 by m is the slope of the normal. Okay, that is a only change here. Right, and another important point, suppose my tangent is parallel to x-axis, this is a tangent to any some curve. So this is a tangent, sir. This tangent is parallel to my x-axis, sir. Then what to do, sir? If tangent is parallel to x-axis means, actually what is this? The theta means the angle, the tangent line making an angle with the x-axis. But here my tangent is parallel to x-axis. My angle will be zero. Theta will be zero. Theta zero means tan theta zero. Tan theta is zero. Okay. So that means my slope is zero. So therefore, if tangent parallel to x-axis, okay, then dy by dx equal to zero. Okay, pa? This is my slope. My slope is zero because my tangent is parallel to x-axis. If tangent parallel to y-axis, okay, so then my dy by dx. Look at that. Suppose I'm taking the tangent. This is actually tangent. Okay, so if my tangent is coming like that. So if this is my tangent, okay, right. So this is perpendicular to x-axis, but this is parallel to y-axis. Parallel to y-axis means this is perpendicular to x-axis. That means my angle is 90. That is tan 90. That is a slope. Tan 90 is a slope. Or this is equal to dy by dx at the point x1 comma y1. All are equal. We got some result. These two are equal. Okay. What is my tan 90 value? It is undefined. That means my dy by dx is also undefined. My slope is undefined. Infinity. Then what to do, sir? You can take dy by dx is infinity, or your dy by dx is dx by dy is zero. So once if you get it is parallel to y-axis means you consider your dx by dy as zero. Okay, look at that. My tangent is parallel to x-axis means my dy by dx zero. My tangent is parallel to y-axis means my dx by dy zero. Find dy by dx and take a reciprocal and equate to zero. Okay, right. So these are the informations. So based on that, we'll discuss some problem. That is a 13th problem in DCA 6.3. Okay, find the points. The question is find the points. Find the points on the curve. x² by 9 minus y square by 16 is equal to 1. At which the tangent are parallel. Yeah, you can write. But you cannot conclude that you cannot find the points. You can write dx by dy is infinity also, correct. But if you know dy by dx or dx by dy equal to zero, then we can conclude something. We can easily find out this point. If you equate to zero, then we can take it as, we can kind of easily find out these points. Infinity means it is not possible to find out the points. So therefore, I am changing from infinity to zero because this is not at all possible to proceed. Okay, I never conclude anything from this result. Okay, so therefore I am changing. Why are you changing again this? Okay. So at which the tangents are, number one, parallel to x-axis. B, parallel to y-axis. Okay. Right, now come to the first one. First of all, differentiate that. This is differentiate this 2x by 9. X square differentiation is 2x. My y square is 2y, but we have to write dy by dx. My x derivative, x is the independent variable, y is the dependent variable. So therefore, when you differentiate with respect to x, my y differentiation is dy by dx. Okay, and my right hand side is zero. I need only dy by dx. This is actually y by 8 into dy by dx equal to minus 2x by 9. So this is dy by dx equal to minus 2x by 9 into y by 8 can be written as 8 by y. Okay, so therefore this is nothing but minus 16x by 9y. Now come to the first one. What is first one? Tangent parallel to x-axis. Tangent parallel to x-axis mean which is equal to 0? My dy by dx is 0. Just now we have told tangent parallel to x-axis mean dy by dx equal to 0. Dy by dx equal to 0 mean this is my dy by dx. Minus 16x divided by 9y should be 0. If this is 0 means you bring this everything. This is minus 16x is equal to 0. My x is equal to 0. Are you okay, pa? My x is equal to is the point. That means at this point only some point is there. At this point my tangent is parallel to x-axis. Okay. Right, I have only x coordinate. We have to find out y coordinate because the question is find the points. Points means we have to find out the x coordinate and y coordinate. That means the question is at which point the tangent is parallel to x-axis. Okay, right, we are going to find out the points. I got my x coordinate. Substitute this x coordinate here. When x is equal to 0, what is the answer for y? This is 0, y square is equal to 16, my y is equal to plus or minus 4. When x is equal to 0, my y is equal to plus or minus 4. Are you okay? There are two points at 0, 4 and 0, minus 4. Okay, actually what is this curve? What is the name of this curve? Students, what is the name of this curve? Name of the curve? The curve is ellipse. Okay, x square by 9 plus y square by 16 means the curve is ellipse but coming like that. Okay, so therefore this is one point. This is a point of 0, plus 4. This is 0, minus 4. At these two points, okay, at these two points, my tangents are parallel to x-axis. Look at that. This is my x-axis. This is my tangent 1. This is my tangent 2. At these two points, I'm getting two tangents and both the tangents are parallel to x-axis. What are the points? 0, 4, 0, minus 4. Okay. Come to the second case. What is my second case? What about your second case? Tangent is parallel to y-axis. Which is parallel to y-axis? My tangent is parallel to y-axis. Okay. Tangent is parallel to y-axis means I have told that my dy by dx is infinity. Or otherwise, you can take it as dx by dy is equal to 0. Right. What is the dy by dx actually? Look at that, your dy by dx is minus 16x by 9y. Okay, so therefore you take a reciprocal, 9y divided by minus 9y divided by 16x equal to 0, which implies your y is equal to 0. Okay, if when y is equal to 0, what is your x? Apply here, y is equal to 0. When y is equal to 0, my x square is equal to 9, my x is equal to plus or minus 3. So therefore, when y is equal to 0, my x is equal to plus or minus 3. So therefore, the points are Okay, at these two points, my tangents are parallel. Look at that. Similarly, this is the point. X is 3 and y is 0. This is 3 comma 0. This is minus 3 comma 0. Okay, pa? At this point, okay, look at that. These two tangents passing through the 3 comma 0 minus 3 comma 0, both are parallel to y axis. That is the question. So therefore the points are, okay, 3 comma 0 minus 3 comma 0. There are two points. Are you okay, pa? Are you clear? Parallel to x axis, parallel to y axis. Any other doubts? If you have any doubts, you please. Or any other problem, if you want, you please tell me, I will work out. If you have any doubt, you please ask your doubts. Okay, look at the question. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve y is equal to 3x power 4 minus 4x at x is equal to 4. What is the slope? Find the slope of the tangent to the curve y is equal to mx power 4, 3x power 4 minus 4x. So slope of the tangent means that is dy by dx at the point given point x is equal to 4. You have to find out dy by dx at x is equal to 4. That is my slope of the tangent. That means dy by dx, that is 3 fourths at 12x minus 4. 12x cube, 4x cube, 4 is 12x cube minus 4. And at this point, apply 0. Okay, when apply 0, it is minus 4. That's all. Slope is minus 4. My slope of the tangent is equal to minus 4. Suppose they are asking slope of the normal. This is actually slope of the tangent. Okay, slope of the normal means, okay, slope of the normal means you take a reciprocal, okay, and take the minus sign also, minus half 1 by m. So therefore this is plus 1 by 4. That is the slope of the normal, okay. Are you okay, pa? Look at that. Find the equation of the tangent. Suppose they are asking find the equation of the tangent. Find the equation of the tangent to the curve y is equal to x square minus 2x plus 7, which is parallel to, which is parallel to 2x minus y plus 9 equal to 0. Okay, find the equation of the tangent. Actually, what is the equation of the tangent? Find the equation of the tangent. What is the equation of the tangent? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Okay, x1 y1 is the point of contact, point of tangent. Okay, we need this x1, y1 and we need this slope also. Okay, so how to find out, sir? So from the given curve, look at that. What is given curve? Y is equal to x square minus 2x plus 7. Find dy by dx. My dy by dx is equal to 2x minus 2. Okay. Now look at that. This line 2x minus y plus 9 is equal to 0. This can be written as y is equal to 2x plus 9. That means this is y is equal to mx plus c. What is your m? Your m is equal to 2. M means the slope of the line. Please see the diagram. My curve is here. My tangent is here. This is my tangent. This is my line. Something y is equal to that 2x plus 9. I don't know the exact line. I'm just drawing the rough line. These two are parallel. The parallel lines having the same slope. That means the angle is same. Tan of the angle is the slope. Okay, the slope must be same. If the lines are parallel, then the slopes are equal. So here, this is my slope of the tangent. And here, this is my slope of the line. Both are equal. That means my 2x minus 2 equal to 2. Okay, my 2x is equal to 4. My x is equal to 2. Okay. If you get the x is equal to 2, apply in this given one, you will get it as y. When x is equal to 2, what is your y? My y is equal to 2 square 4. 2 into 2, that is also 4. This is 7. This is cancelled. I will get y is equal to 7. This is the point. Yeah, at this point only we are getting the tangent. That is, this is the point 2,7. This is the point some 2,7. Okay. Actually, this is my x1. This is my y1. So therefore, now you can easily find out your equation of the tangent. What is my equation of the tangent? Y minus my y1 is 7. My m, slope of the tangent. Slope of the tangent and slope of the given line, both are equal because both are parallel. That is 2 into x minus x1. My x1 is 2. So therefore, y minus 7 is equal to 2x minus 4. Which implies, you bring all the terms to the one side. My 2x plus y, this is minus 2x, this is plus y. Minus 7, my plus 4, that is minus 3, equal to 0. And remove your minus, 2x minus y plus 3 is equal to 0. Are you okay, Pa? Both are correct. This is also correct, sir. In my option, this is given, sir. In my 4 options, this is given, sir. Yeah, this is also correct. Sir, in my option, this is given, sir. This is also correct. Both are correct. Okay, pa? Any other doubt? You please ask your doubts if you can. Perpendicular means, look at that. The same line, y is equal to 2x square minus 2x plus 7. Okay, this is this line, the for this curve, my tangent is perpendicular to this line. 5y minus 15x equal to 13. See the curve? See the diagram? Actually, this is my tangent and this is the line, another some line is there here. This is my perpendicular line. Perpendicular line means the lines are perpendicular, then the product of the slopes is equal to minus 1. You can take the tangent slope is m1 and this slope is m2. Okay, this slope you can easily get it. How to get it? The slope of this one. This is actually y is equal to, you bring this 15 to the right hand side. So therefore 15 by 5, 3x. Okay, so this is 13 by 5. Actually, this is my slope. my m is equal to 3. This is a slope. Okay, this is a slope of this perpendicular line, but I need the slope of the tangent. You can take slope of the tangent is m1 and slope of this perpendicular line is m2, that is minus 1. This is the known result. So therefore, I need this m1. M1 means slope of the tangent, and this is 3 equal to minus 1. My slope of the tangent is minus 1 by 3. Okay, the tangent is perpendicular to the line means, so you consider the slope of this line and take a reciprocal and opposite sign also, that is minus 1 by 3. So therefore, my m is equal to minus 1 by 3. And my dy by dx is equal to, this is 2x minus 2. Now compare these two, everything is equal. Compare this, you will get x and y coordinates. That are the points. Okay, pa? Any other doubts? Okay. So don't have any doubt means we close this session. And try to write sincerely the tomorrow's test. Tangent normal, increasing and decreasing function. Please work out today. The question paper is a very easiest question paper. And most of the questions, your NCERT based questions only. Simple questions, NCERT based questions only. Okay. So therefore, once if you thorough all the NCERT problems and ideas, okay, if you thorough all the concepts in your, given in your NCERT, definitely you can get 100 out of 100 in the test. Okay, pa? Yeah, do well. And if you have any doubt, you send your doubts, I will reply you. Okay. Thank you all. Thank you so much. Okay. Nagarjuna, you please work out that 18th problem, otherwise I will do that. Okay. Okay, pa. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.